Our theme, as you know, is powered by purpose. And so my responsibility is to introduce us to and to kind of draw us in to this incredible topic. And as I was preparing, I couldn't help but think about something that one of my best friends and my mentor, Charlie Renfro, taught me when I was very, very young. He said, Andy, always remember that there are two immutable laws in life. And the two immutable laws in life are this, that everybody has got to eat and live indoors. Everybody's got to eat and live indoors. I don't see anybody writing that down. Everybody's got to eat and live indoors. Now, this is important as it relates to our topic because our topic is purpose. And until you are eating and living indoors, you do not have time or the margin to think about purpose, which means there are people in the world today that purpose is the least of their worries. It is the last thing on their mind. But if you're a part of this gathering, either in the room or gathered with us at a host site, you're a person that has probably moved beyond eating and living indoors, but we're going to come back to that in just a few minutes. You're a person who has the margin and perhaps the education and the life experience to ask the bigger questions, the why questions, the purpose questions. And although I know this, not all of us are all that interested in purpose, either because of you're just too busy doing other stuff, you've never been introduced to anything that kind of jazzed you up around the idea of purpose, perhaps because of where you are in your career. Again, you say, Andy, that's great. I'm sure for some people they have time for that, but not for me. But here's what I think all know if we stop and think about it for just a few minutes. At some point in all of our lives, all of us will be interested in the topic of purpose. And here's why I say that. Because after you go to a few funerals, you realize that at the end of anyone's life, regardless of what kind of life they actually lived, right? Regardless of what kind of life they actually lived, somebody at their funeral service is gonna look for something to say that's meaningful. We're gonna come back to that word in just a minute. That we try to mine out of every single life something that's purposeful. And the reason is this, it is in you and it is in me. It's unavoidable. It's in you and it's in me to want to make some sort of difference or to want to find some meaning in life, which is a link to our topic, purpose. The other reason I say that is this. Through the years, I have literally talked to dozens and dozens of men and women, generally in their mid to late 50s, and they say things like this, Andy, I've had a good career. Andy, I've built a good business. Andy, I've made plenty of money. Andy, I feel like I've had a very blessed life. You know, I feel like God has blessed my life. I've just been lucky. But I'm at this stage in my life where I want to do something that makes a difference. I want to do something that has a little bit more meaning. I want to do something that has a little bit more purpose. I'll tell you something I've never heard. I've never talked to anybody in their mid to late 50s who said this, Andy, my whole life I've been doing meaningful things and I'm tired of it. Andy, my whole life I've had the privilege to help other people and to make the world a better place and I'm sick of it. And for these next few years, I want to do something that has absolutely no meaning at all. Can you help me? Never heard that. Because regardless of what season of life you're in and regardless of what's going on in your life right now and regardless of how purposeless perhaps what you do day in and day out may feel and seem like and look like, there's something in you, there's something in me that wants more. Now, most people are never powered by purpose. And the reason they're never powered by purpose is because purpose has a gotcha. Purpose has a twist. Purpose has there's an angle to purpose that most people miss. And the twist, the gotcha, is actually found in the definition. The definition of purpose is this. It's the reason for which something exists or is accomplished. You already knew that. Purpose is simply the reason for which something exists or is accomplished. And here's the gotcha, and here's the tension, and here's what we're gonna wrestle to the ground for just the next few minutes. No, and nobody really wants to be the reason. Everybody wants to be the something. Most people don't want to be a reason for something. Most people want to be a something. Or let me just put it this way. Purpose is a means to an end. Purpose is a means to an end. It's not the end. Purpose is a means to an end. And most people are not willing to be a means. Most people want to be the end. Most people insist on being the end. So consequently, because we don't understand, because purpose is costly, as we're gonna see in just a minute, because most people intuitively don't wanna be a means to an end, because most of us wanna be the end, it's easy to live our entire lives and never embrace purpose and get to the end of our lives and look back and ask the question that so many people ask, I wonder if there was something more. But in the meantime, when it comes to purpose, I think we oftentimes ask the wrong questions because we don't understand that purpose is a means to an end. We ask questions like this, you know, what is my purpose? And why do we ask the question, what is my purpose? If you ever stop long enough to ask that question, I want to know my purpose so that I won't be without purpose. And it all comes back to me. Or we ask this question, why am I here? Why am I here? I want to know why I'm here so I'll know why I'm here so that when I'm not here, people will know that I had been there. Why am I here? The reason I want to know why I'm here, I want to know why I'm here so that when I'm not here, people will know that I was there. And once again, it comes back to me. Because it is not intuitive, and I don't think it's natural for anybody to want to be a means to an end, but until you are willing to be a means to an end, you will never, ever, ever, in your company, in your organization, in your department, in your division, or even in your personal life, to ever be a person who's powered and empowered by purpose. The starting point for the discovery of purpose is not, what am I here for? Perhaps the starting point for purpose is this question, who am I here for? Or when you think about your organization or your franchise, your division or your startup, who are we here for? Because if you don't hear anything else that I say for the next few minutes, I want you to hear this, that purpose is always found. Purpose is always found just across the border from what's in it for me. To be empowered by purpose, you must be willing in some capacity to be a means to an end that is not you. It means saying no to you so you can say to yes, so you can say yes to something that's bigger and broader than you. Which means, as you've already discovered, that purpose has a price. And this is why so many people live their entire lives and never embrace any sense of purpose. I'll tell you somebody who understands this. It's Larry Merlot. Larry Merlot is currently the president and the CEO of CVS Pharmacies. I'm sure we have some CVS Pharmacy fans in the house, or you're watching, those of us that use CVS Pharmacy. It's my choice of pharmacy, just saying. Anyway, he understands this because years ago, CVS found itself in a wrestling match internally over profit and purpose. Profit and purpose. And in 2014, you may know this, in 2014, CVS became the very first major pharmacy, the very first major pharmacy chain in America to stop selling cigarettes and to stop selling tobacco-related products. Now, this was not a casual decision, because even in the decision-making process, the company and Larry in particular knew that this was not going to cost CVS millions of dollars. But even initially, this would cost CVS billions of dollars. And here's what he said. I love this quote. He said, put simply, the sale of tobacco products is inconsistent with our purpose. The sale of tobacco products is inconsistent with our purpose. And CVS had a very tightly designed purpose statement, which was simply helping people, and I love this, helping people on their path to better health. Helping people on their path to better health. So we're trying to help people on their path to better health. That's a great purpose statement. At the same time, we are selling products that undermine people's personal health. And there was a tension between profit and purpose. And under his leadership, CVS decided to go with purpose over profit, but it was costly. It cost them billions of dollars because purpose has a price. So, while all of us admire purposeful people, right? And while most of us even admire purposeful companies, most of us will be tempted to sit on the sidelines because the price is too high. The other thing you need to understand about purpose, and this is going to be illustrated throughout our day together, is that purpose is actually a path to to meaning. And let me explain this for just a minute. You see, because purpose requires us to be a means to an end, think with me, because purpose requires us to be a means to an end, then the only way to have meaning in life is to be a means to an end, which is how you embrace purpose. So that once you embrace the idea of being empowered by purpose, you become a means to an end, and that is how you find meaning. That is what meaning actually means. Meaning means that you become a means. So whenever you hear people ask this question, and perhaps you've asked this question, isn't there more to this life? Isn't there more to this life? There's got to be more to this life. You've thought that. You felt that. You've laid in bed at night in the dark thinking, there's got to be more to this life. Do you know what you're actually saying? Do you know what the people who say that are actually saying? They're saying this. There's got to be more to this life than me. Because there is no meaning if you're not willing to move beyond me. And meaning is the path. Meaning is a pathway. I think it's the pathway to purpose. But in order to get there, you have to become a means to an end. That's what meaning actually means. You know this. Those who devote themselves to themselves will ultimately have nothing but themselves to show for themselves. Isn't that true? Those who devote themselves to themselves will ultimately have nothing but themselves to show for themselves. You've met people like this. Because of what I do for a living, I've been to too many funerals where we had to think really long and hard. Where we've had to work really long and hard with family saying, you gotta give me something. You're not giving me anything. What can I say about your grandfather? What can I say about your aunt? You gotta give me something. Because a person that lives for themselves, regardless of what they accomplish and what they own, at the end of the day, those who devote themselves to themselves will ultimately have nothing but themselves to show for themselves. And this is true of your division and your company as well. I tell the folks in my church all the time that your glory is too small a thing for you to live for. And when you live for your glory, when you live for yourself, you get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. And you know this. You were made for more. You were actually designed with purpose in mind. And that's why you admire it. And that's why when you hear some of the stories you're gonna hear today, and when you meet some of the people that you're gonna meet today, you're gonna be inspired. And as you're being inspired, you need to ask yourself this question. Why is this so inspiring? On one hand, I'm challenged. On one hand, I'm not sure I would have done what they did, yet I admire what they did. Why is it I'm inspired by their story, and yet there's something in me that resists the whole notion of stepping into that space? Why is it that if you were on the board of CVS or if you were part of the team that was making that decision and you realize this is gonna cost us and this is gonna cost stockholders and this is gonna cost us ultimately billions of dollars, and as you wrestled with that tension while we admire CVS, why is it there's something in us that resists stepping in to that space? That's why you're here. That's why we're gonna spend an entire day talking about purpose. Because if you devote yourself to more than yourself, you will ultimately have more than yourself to show for yourself. And we've never met, we've never had a conversation, but I know this about you. At the end of your life, at the end of your career, when you sell your company, when they give you the gold watch, when you go home and they take your fob with a smile on their face and you can't wait to give it to them anyway, right? When you get to that place, whether it's a transition to a different career, transition to a different company, whatever it is, This is what you're gonna wanna have as the story of your life. Those who devote themselves to more than themselves will ultimately have more than themselves to show for themselves. So, summing up real quick. Purpose is a means to an end. Purpose has a price, that's why people shy away. And purpose is a path, a pathway to meaning. Which means today, we hope that you are willing to at least consider, becoming a means to an end, which means that's a decision you have to make. Now, I know the challenge is, well, Andy, you don't know what I do, and you don't know what kind of company I'm in, and you don't know where I am in the company, you don't understand what I do. You're exactly right, but here's what I do understand. At some point, you have to decide for you, am I willing to become a means to an end? Let me put it this way. Would you rather be the shovel or the hole? If you didn't like that one, would you rather be the plunger? Okay, you got it. All right, now, I have a friend that many of you have met because she's no stranger to leadership. Her name is Cheryl Batchelder. And Cheryl Batchelder, in the year 2007, became the CEO of Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen, or we just call it Popeye's Chicken around here. She became the CEO. During that time, she wrote an incredible book called Dare to Serve. And during that time, if you had purchased the stock when she became the CEO, it would have cost you about $13. And if you had held on to that stock until just a few weeks ago, when Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen sold, it sold for just under $80. So Cheryl Batchelder is an extraordinary leader, an extraordinary CEO, an extraordinary person, an extraordinary wife, an extraordinary mother. I mean, she's been there, she's done that. And yet when she thinks about leadership and thought about leadership, I want you to look at what she said about this subject of purpose, and then I'm going to give you some steps, some things to do. Here's what she said. I love this quote. She said, the point of purpose, now this is somebody who's been there and done that, okay? The point of purpose is to determine how you will serve others. That's the point. That's her way of saying, if you're going to live a life of purpose, you must decide that you are willing to become a means to an end that is not you. That is how you become meaningful. I love this. The point of purpose is to determine how you will serve others. If you don't plan to serve, you don't need a purpose. This is so powerful. You cannot divorce purpose from service. You cannot divorce purpose from becoming a means to an end that is not you. And that's the challenge. And honestly, folks, that's why most people miss it. But it's why at the end of all of our lives, we would be willing to give up a lot to come back, maybe to this moment, maybe to this season of our lives, and learn to leverage it and to live for it. So here's three things you can begin doing actually today. Sort of three kind of baby steps as we think about how to get from where we are to embracing a life of purpose and being empowered by purpose. The first one is simply this, is to begin looking at everything you are currently doing through the lens of means. Now this is a mental shift, but if you've been in leadership for very long or if you've lived for very long, you know this, that most of the great changes you've made in your life began with a shift in your thinking. This is a mental shift that could lead to extraordinary things. It's to begin looking at everything you are currently doing through the lens of means. What I mean by that is simply this. Our tendency is to look at most of what we do through the lens of an end. But since purpose is a means to an end, anytime you make an end a means, you have embraced purpose. Anytime you make what you normally consider an end a means to an end, you have embraced purpose. For example, you may be someone who says, well, Andy, I just have a dead-end job. Well, you got to remember what Charlie said. Everybody's got to eat and live indoors. So if your dead-end job allows you to eat and live indoors, your dead-end job is a means to an end, right? Well, Andy, I'm just paying the bills. Do you know what happens when you stop? Come on. You don't just teach school. You don't just manage budgets. You don't just do accounting. You don't just sell real estate. You don't just sell automobiles. Hey, parents, come on. You're not just raising kids. Parents, your greatest contribution to the world may not be something you do, but someone you raise. Your greatest contribution to this world may not be something you do, but someone you raise. The first step in understanding and embracing purpose is to create the mental habit of looking at everything you are currently doing through the lens of means. Everything becomes a means to an end. Second thing is this, is to pay attention to what stirs your heart. 2 years ago when I was here, I challenged you with this question. I asked you this question. Some of you may remember it. I said, hey, what breaks your heart? What breaks your heart? What stirs your heart? Let me ask you this way. What would you like people to line up at the end of your life to thank you for? What would you like people to line up at the end of your life to thank you for? What stirs your heart? What breaks your heart? What just gets you emotional? What are the stories that you just can't walk away from without wiping a tear from your eye? What is the theme that you come back every once in a while? You just can't get it off your mind. Every time there's a story on television about it, you're just locked in. What breaks your heart? What stirs your heart? Listen to this. Purpose is often found at the intersection of a broken heart, opportunity, and skill. Individual purpose, corporate purpose is often found at the intersection of a broken heart, opportunity, and skill. The other thing that you can do immediately is to begin surrounding yourself with people, or on-purpose people. Surround yourself with some on-purpose people. People, an on-purpose person, surround yourself with people who aren't afraid to give themselves to something more than themselves, who aren't afraid to give themselves to something bigger than themselves. Because both self-centeredness, you know this, self-centeredness and selflessness, they're both contagious. Generosity is contagious. Greed is contagious. And at the end of the day, I mean, you tell your kids this all the time. These are just my words for something you've tried to tell your kids. But this is true for you. It's true for me. That our friends, isn't it true? That our friends determine the direction and the quality of our lives. So in order to embrace purpose, in order to begin thinking in terms of means rather than an end, you've got to surround yourself with some people who think the very same way. In fact, if you're a parent, a little parenting advice real quick. The next time one of your kids wants a tattoo, okay, some of you are in that battle right now, you just say yes, you can have a tattoo, and you take him and you get this tattooed on the inside of both wrists. So when they're walking around all day doing this, they'll see, my friends will determine the direction and quality of my life. Okay, that's probably worth the price of the conference. So anyway, so purpose is a means to an end. Wrap it up. Purpose is a means to an end. Purpose has a price. And purpose is a path or a pathway to meaning. So the question that we want you to wrestle with for our hours together is, am I willing to become a means rather than the end? Because if the answer is no, you'll spend this next season of your life without purpose. You'll do some great things. You may make a lot of money, and you may be happy. But in terms of embracing purpose, it begins with the decision. Am I willing to become the reason for something instead of the something? A means to an end instead of just the end. Are you willing to position your organization? This is a tough one. But organizations have done this. Are you willing to position your organization as a means to an end that's broader than the bottom line? You'll be glad you did. Or I think you'll wish you had. I'll close with this. I have a friend, Tom Rhodes, who is a very successful architect in the Atlanta area. And he's become a good friend over these years. And about 6 or 7 years ago, Tom heard that in our church, we needed somebody to give leadership to our special needs environment. We have an environment for special needs kids on Sundays so that their parents can, you know, go to church and not be distracted. And so Tom did not have special needs kids. Tom had no necessary, you know, didn't have a broken heart over special needs kids, but this is what we needed done. And he said, hey, if that's what my church needs, that's what I'll do. So Tom began volunteering in this incredible environment and sometimes this incredibly challenging environment with special needs kids. And it got hold of his heart and he never missed. Then Tom found out that every year we send 2 or 3 groups of people to East Asia to work with special needs kids in some environments where the single child policy leaves a lot of kids without a home. So we send groups of people all over, you know, to the East Asia primarily to work with kids. So Tom took one of these trips, and a second, and a third. Now he's been on 5 of these trips. So we were interviewing Tom about this because he's such an extraordinary person, very successful in his career, and yet so passionate about this thing with special needs kids, even though his kids aren't special needs. And in this interview, he made a statement that I want to leave you with because I think this is the whole thing wrapped up in a single quote. Here's what he said. He said, it's difficult just to go back to a normal everyday Sunday once you've tasted purpose. It's difficult to go back to just a normal everyday, you know, normal Sunday once you've tasted purpose. In other words, once you have decided, I'm willing to take a chance of being a means rather than an end. I'm willing to step into being a reason rather than the something. I'm willing to step into something that's bigger and grander than me, even though it will cost me something. Tom says, I believe, some of you know from personal experience, that once you step into that realm, there is no going back. It's difficult to go back to a normal everyday Sunday once you've tasted purpose. We hope that today we whet your appetite.